Have you ever prepared mayonnaise? Did you know that this popular sauce is based on the emulsion of oil in the water containing the egg yolk? Practically, mayonnaise is the result of the combination of two immiscible liquids obtained by spreading small drops of one, the dispersed phase, into the other, the dispersant. The preparation of mayonnaise is a typical mixing problem, in which putting in contact proper fractions of ingredients with adequate speed and homogeneity plays a major role. The problem usually takes some manual skills and appropriate kitchen tools to be addressed. Therefore, we could simply state that it is a problem that can be approached via an empirical route. Sometimes, it is not so easy to face a problem and to create experimental settings for assessing a solution, as in your kitchen. Maybe the reactor is large, or the process is difficult to replicate and control. In many cases, a numerical experiment based on a mathematical model could provide a solution for this kind of problems. A model is a reproduction of reality, in which relevant problem features are simulated, usually with the support of computational tools, to relate system inputs and outputs. Looking at water treatment and management, there are many examples of the effective use of models. Think at water disinfection, in which a chlorine-based compound is typically dosed in water for inactivating pathogens. In the view of maximizing the process performance while limiting its drawbacks, as the generation of harmful byproducts, we must put water in contact with an optimal dosage of the disinfectant for a defined time. It is not so different from the mayonnaise example. Only disinfection reactors are orders of magnitude larger, have a much more complex geometry, and fluids are transparent. Chlorine-based disinfection can be successfully modeled and optimized by knowing the physical, chemical, and biological governing laws for describing the involved phenomena as the fluid dynamics, the behavior of the disinfectant in water, and the inactivation of pathogens. Such model, based on the knowledge of governing laws, is called a mechanistic model. For its application, it is necessary to define a spatial and temporal framework for solving the mathematical equations of the governing laws. In case of reactors with complex geometries, we need to divide the domain into a set of small elements, the mesh, and to solve the characteristic equations in each element. As an example, for modeling the fluid dynamics, we must solve the Navier-Stokes equation in every element of the reactor. Computational fluid dynamics, or CFD, is the usual name for computational models applying this approach. CFD was initially used for the problems related to the fluid motion, but its application was then extended to many other physical, chemical, and biological phenomena. In principle, whatever physics can be described if we know its characteristic equation. Looking at our example, we can replace the chlorine-based disinfectant with UV radiation, another widespread disinfecting agent for water treatment. In such case, we must include the radiative transfer equation to simulate the propagation of UV radiation inside the reactor. Now, let's model a typical pressurized vessel for UV disinfection. It is a stainless steel cylinder in which the water flows from one side to the other. During its passage, the water is irradiated by the UV lamp positioned in the middle, and the pathogens are inactivated. The sequence for modeling such reactor is the following. Reproduce the geometry in the virtual environment. Create the mesh. Define and solve the characteristic equations. In this case, we have the Navier-Stokes equation for fluid dynamics, the radiative transfer equation for the UV propagation, and the Chick and Watson equation for pathogen inactivation. The modeling results for the reactor operated at steady state are shown, so you can see the water velocity, the UV radiation intensity, and the concentration of pathogens inside the reactor. There are all the elements required for a comprehensive assessment of process performance and, ultimately, for the optimization of reactor design and operation. It is up to you to decide what to do. On the other hand, in case we don't know all characteristic equations or the problem is much more complex, black box model can be applied. This latter group of models also contains the so-called machine learning, which are the modeling techniques on which is based significant part of the so-called artificial intelligence. In this case, instead of simulating the process in detail, the model is derived from a set of data. Continuing with our example, this modeling approach can be applied to study a UV disinfection system in which hundreds of UV lamps are applied, as it occurs in large-scale water treatment plants. Such approach, although it does not allow to properly know the local value of variables inside the reactor CFD, makes it possible to deal with case studies that would require large amounts of computational resources if assessed by a CFD software. And this is just a taste of what you can do. Many other tools and applications are just behind the corner.